back up, but Cletus has had his shots. I'll tell you this, he's got some interesting stains. I'm not sure whether he's been trapping or fishing or hunting or what. Speaking of flags, I'm sure that they're going to be waving their flag high in the air over this match because they're going to have to, because Patriot and Vader are going to have the crowd on their side.
54 pounds, the Patriot and the man they call Vader.
I'm sure some folks are a little bit skeptical that Vader and the Patriot will be able to peaceably coexist because, quite frankly, Vader has never peaceably coexisted with anybody in his life. Not a single other human being, JR, has Vader ever been able to get along with. I can say this, they've got common enemies. That's their only bond. If Patriot holds up his end of the bargain, they should be all right. But if he feels, if Vader feels let down in any way, then he'll lash out against anybody. In addition to the flag match we discussed on pay-per-view next Sunday, the Godwins will also meet the Headbangers, Thrasher and Mosh, who have become extremely, extremely popular WWF Tag Champions, and that will be for Tag Team Gold on pay-per-view next Sunday at 7 o'clock. Well, not only have the Headbangers become popular, they've also become an entirely different team with the newfound confidence of their first Tag Team Championship being the WWF Tag Team title. But don't forget, the Godwins hold a non-title victory over the Headbangers, and they're looking to repeat that when the title's on the line and it really counts. Vader at 458 pounds, locking up with Henry Godwin, and Henry's got to be well over 300 pounds himself. Both these guys rivaling Bill Parcells as far as girth is concerned. Up swing and a miss, the thumb in the eye. That's a pretty good counter move. Thumb of the eye, one of the favorite holds of Cactus Jack, who made his Madison Square Garden debut this past Monday night in that Falls Count Anywhere, Falls Count Anywhere matchup. And what a clothesline by big old Hank Godwin knocking down Vader.
Boy, and you can safely say that Madison Square Garden's seen a lot, but they have never seen some of the things they saw from Cactus Jack. It was unbelievable.
Henry Godwin is relentless in his attack, a physical attack on the man they call Vader, and Henry tags in his brother Phineas. Ooh, and I hear that Uncle Cletus is not only their uncle, but their first cousin. And if any of you folks out there in New York City can figure that one out, somebody just drop us a card and let us know how that works.
Well, it's real easy. You see, I've been involved in that situation before. Now,
there's
what
a
happened?
Tag, never mind. The genealogy lesson from our resident historian.
Just well, trying to help.
Well, they can write for your newsletter or something. The Patriot in, knocking down Phineas, and Phineas makes a counter, but it's countered back into a hip lock by the Patriot, going upstairs with a drop kick, and the former All-Japan wrestling star, the former All-American offensive lineman at South Carolina, building an advantage here. You know he's the biggest gamecock of them all.
And Patriot now, he is cooking outside, and wait a minute, he's a one-man gang. He's fighting off both Henry and Phineas, the whole Godwin family. And I'll tell you something, JR, talking about family and family values, the Goldust and Marlena family at Bad Blood's going to be a little bit different twist. Dude Love is going to take on Brian Pillman. If Dude Love beats Pillman, then Pillman will have to face Goldust in a no DQ match immediately afterwards, and Goldust will be handcuffed to the ring post while the Dudester and Pillman go at it.
And I got to believe that Dude Love is going to rise to the occasion as he always does on pay-per-view. And take care of Brian Pillman. Hey, that's a pretty good counter by Phineas Godwin. You know, the interesting thing about that situation with Dude Love and Pillman next Sunday on pay-per-view is that if Dude does win the matchup, and I suspect he will, Goldust will then face Pillman immediately in a anything-goes, no-disqualification fight.
No delay, no rest, and they're going to jump in the ring right then and go at it. And I tell you, I got to wonder who Marlena's going to be rooting for. I mean, this is starting to get complicated.
Well, I think she's going to be rooting for her husband.
Well, I'll tell you what, Pillman has done a lot for her. He's done some makeovers on her. Jenny Jones couldn't touch with a 15-foot pole.
Well, I don't find it very nice that Marlena's been forced to succumb to that psychotic madman, Brian Pillman's whims, you know, pierce this body part and get another tattoo. And I mean, she's going to be marked for life after this experience.
Both mentally and physically, but she's looking like a fine, upstanding young lady. And right now, speaking of fine and upstanding, the most upstanding citizens of Bitters, Ark, Arkansas are doing a number on America's number one Patriot.
The Patriot now fighting back, landing those blows to the midsection of Phineas Godwin, and Phineas raking the face again.
You can't hardly miss Phineas's midsection, but it seems to be able to absorb a lot of punishment.
Pretty good jawbreaker there. They put the knot on the old noggin of Phineas Godwin. In any event, the Godwins have the advantage.
And wait a minute now, what's Henry doing? Oh, the stars and bars coming into play and into very good use here as the Patriot fighting for air.
Well, that stars and bars is offensive anyway. The Godwin's odor is offensive. And the actions recently of Uncle Cletus is offensive. And I'm offended. There's a lateral press.
Well, don't offend me.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back. Don't go away. Welcome back, everybody, to WWF New York. It's the Patriot Invader meeting the Godwins. The Patriot just knocked down with that knee to the midsection by Big Phineas Godwin. And Phineas makes the tag to Henry. Boy, we have seen some intense action in this. And when you talk about intensity, you got to wonder, how intense will it be when Vince McMahon calls out Stone Cold Steve Austin this Monday night on Raw? And Austin very well could be fired this Monday night, and that would be the last time that we would see Stone Cold Steve Austin in the WWF. And if that is the case, James E., what do you think Austin's answer to Vince McMahon's going to be?
Well, McMahon tried to help him, and he dropped him on his head, so I have to think, JR, as I told you privately, Steve Austin will whip Vince McMahon's hind keister if he gets fired on national television.
Another big matchup this Monday night on Raw will be a semifinal match in the Intercontinental Title Tournament. Ahmed Johnson and Farouk will determine who will meet Owen Hart in the finals. That'll be this Monday, that semifinal matchup.
Sunset
on Raw.
Flip.
Sunset flip. Is that no? Referee was detained about a second, maybe two, and long enough for Phineas Godwin to regroup, shall we say.
And Farouk's got new life in the tournament because Ken Shamrock defeated him to advance, but Shamrock suffered a torn lung, internal injuries, and could not continue, so Farouk was named as his replacement.
Yeah, and I don't know how sound a decision that Commissioner Slaughter made on that one. You know, some folks are speculating that Slaughter's getting a little intoxicated with the power of his position.
Hey, JR, it's the same rules that they use in the Ultimate Fights. Therefore, Shamrock ought to be used to it. He's benefited from that ruling in the past. Now he's penalized by it. He's got no room to break.
You know, James E., another thing I heard about this Monday's Raw broadcast is the fact that Shawn Michaels and Hunter Hearst Helmsley have requested some interview time, and I hear they got a lot they want to get off their chest.
Well, I would imagine they do. They've got everybody in the world mad at them. They've got the Hart Foundation mad at them. They've got The Undertaker mad at them. They've got everybody all upset with their actions and their controversial outspokenness.
Phineas deviated from his game plan. Went upstairs, now goes downstairs. Ooh. Vader's got the tag, and Vader is just rocking and rolling here.
He's got Cletus. He's got Uncle Cletus. Stop. No. Oh, they stopped short. Thank goodness.
Oh, Uncle Cletus just got knocked off the apron. Look at Vader. Absolutely dominant. Oh, listen to this crowd.
He's going for
Vader bomb.
He got
the
it.
Vader bomb, and that's over. If nobody gets up from the Vader bomb.
Here are your winners, the Red Bull Vader and the Patriot.
Vader and Patriot, JR, on a roll, ready to go to Bad Blood.
What a matchup it will be on pay-per-view next Sunday at 7 o'clock as we take another look at the Vader bomb.
450 pounds across Mr. Godwin. Nobody gets up from it. But will Vader and the Patriot be able to wave Old Glory in the flag match next Sunday?
Ladies and gentlemen, don't forget to join us this Monday night on Raw. For James E. Cornette, I'm Jim Ross. So long, everybody.